Hello, and welcome to Plants and Python. My name is Alejandra Rougon, and I am a professor at the Genomics Department at the National Autonomous University of Mexico, UNAM, Campus Enes León. This is Command Line Lesson 6, Copy, Change Location, and Remove Files. In this lesson, you will learn to copy files and folders, to change location, to remove files, and to use the wildcard star. The command cp is used for copying files and folders. The syntax is cp, the name of the file you want to copy, and then the name of the new file. There are different ways you can use cp. To copy the file to the same location but with a different name. To copy the file or folder to a different location but with the same name. And in this case, you don't have to specify the name, only the new location. And to copy the file to a different location with a different name. In all these options, we are copying a file that is in our working directory. However, we can also copy a file from another location by specifying the path and file name. For example, to copy from location A to location B. Or to copy from location A to our working directory, which is specified by a dot. Now let's try it. First go to your home directory with cd. And now copy the file fruitall that is in your home directory to the folder documents. If we don't specify the name, it will be copied with the same name. Now move to the folder documents. And let's verify that the file fruitall was copied by listing the contents with ls. And there it is. Now let's copy the file fruitall with another name, fruitall copy. And again with ls we verify that it was copied. Remember that you can also check the directory contents in the file browser, which is in the left side of your virtual terminal labeled as file tree. So now we are in the documents folder. Let's copy from our home directory to the documents folder, which is now our working directory. We have to specify the location of the file we want to copy. We can do that using either the relative or the absolute path. Here I am using the relative path. Remember that two dots refer to one folder backward. In other words, the folder containing our current folder. And then if we want to keep the same name, we can just specify the location, which is in this case our working directory, and can be specified with a dot. Now we can do another copy, but with a different name. Remember, cp will keep the original file. However, if you don't want to keep the original file, you can use the command mv. This command will move the file to the new location and will remove the first one. The syntax is the same as cp. Let's move the file contents.txt from the home directory to the working directory, which is at the moment documents. As you can see, the original file has been removed. Now, let's print the path with the command pwd so we can remember the absolute path. And now, with mv, let's move the file fruitall to the current working directory, but with a different name, all fruits. So now the original file fruitall has been removed and we have a copy of it named all fruits. mv can also be used to change the name of a file if both files are in the same location. So our file fruitall is now called new fruitall. The command rm and rmdir are used to remove files and folders respectively. Note that in order to remove a folder, it has to be empty. You have to be very careful when you remove files in the command line, since they will be immediately and permanently removed, and you won't be able to restore them. There is no recycle bin. Okay, let's clean up a bit our home directory. So first, make sure you are in your home directory. Remember that you can go there with cd, and you can verify it with pwd. Now let's see what we have inside. Let's remove the file readme.txt with rm and the name of the file. The virtual terminal is configured to ask you if you want to remove the file, and you can confirm that with the letter Y. However, most terminals won't ask anything and will just remove the file. If we want to remove several files at the same time, we can use wildcards. They are used to perform actions on more than one file at a time, or to find part of a phrase in a text file. At the moment, we will see the wildcard, asterisk, or star, which represents any number of characters. For example, if we use the command ls and we want to list all the files that start with the string gene, we can use star after gene to represent any letter, number, or any other character after string gene. And that will find the files gene, gene1, gene8.txt, genes underscore prod, genomes. It can also be used to find all files with a specific extension, such as .pdf. Now, let's remove the two files with the string fruit. So it would be rm fruit star. And we can check with ls that both files have been removed. In this lesson, you have learned to copy, move, and remove files and folders, and to use the wildcard star to select several files.